Good morning, class. Today, we will be able to perform an experiment entitled Activity 1, Charles Law. But before anything else, I have with me our guest for today to assist us in performing our activity. Are you excited to know her? Let us welcome the very beautiful Miss Liza Nadine Bernardo.
Hi, Sir Nick. I'm so excited to be your assistant for today. Especially, I really love science and chemistry.
Very beautiful. First, what are our objectives for today, Miss Liza?
For our objectives for today, first, define Charles' law operationally. Second, investigate the relationship between volume and temperature at constant pressure. And lastly, appreciate the importance of Charles' law to one's life. What about for our materials needed, Sir Romy?
Materials needed for today's activity are wire gauze, sometimes we're crashing down, tripod, but we get up and start from the ground, thermometer, rubber balloon, tape measure, beaker. Definitely, we will be using 3 beakers with the same amount of measurement. Alcohol lamp with denatured alcohol. And water, we will be using tap water, cold or ice water, and hot water. I think we are now ready to perform our experiment, Miss Liza.
In terms of our materials, if these materials are not readily available, you can use improvised of it. But remember, please be very careful in using fire. You may ask help from your family members if you can't be able to perform some procedures. For our first procedure, prepare 3 beakers, one for hot water, one for cold water, and one for tap water. We can use improvised beaker if you don't have available of it. So you can use big can with microwavable glass or simply casserole. And for the next step, inflate the balloon using a balloon pump. So just like this. So that we will have an inflated balloon. And also measure the circumference of the balloon using a tape measure. So simply like this. You know, in mathematics, your teacher taught you that in order to get a circumference of a particular circle, we need to move or to measure like this. So measure the circumference of the balloon with the use of the tape measure.
For the next procedure, get the temperature reading of the hot water using the thermometer. Then put the balloon in hot water for 2 minutes. Then measure again its circumference. Do 3 trials and get the average of the results.
And for the next procedure, repeat procedures 3 to 6 using tap water. And repeat procedures 3 to 6, this time using ice water.
Record the result in Table 1. Table 1 tells us the data on determining the size of the balloon at different temperatures. So wherein we have the 3 setup: the warm water, the cold water or ice water, and the tap water. We have also the average temperature in terms of degrees Celsius and average circumference of the balloon in centimeter. So we have before trial, after trial, and we will be going to get the average of the two trials.
Wow, Sir Nick! After they have completed the data of Table 1, it's about time for them to answer the guide questions.
Yes, beautiful, Liza! So here are the guide questions. Number 1. What happens to the size of the balloon as the temperature decreases? 2. How does the change in the temperature relate to the volume of the gas in the balloon? And last but not the least, guide question number 3. How will you define Charles' law based on the experiments?
Thank you everyone for listening to us. This is Liza and Nadine Bernardo. See ya!
Yes, Liza. Thank you and have a wonderful day.